Nigeria jaga jaga. Everything scatter scatter. Roma de suffer suffer. Boza boza. Gunshot in the air, sing with me. Nigeria jaga jaga. Everything scatter scatter. Roma de suffer suffer. Boza boza. Gunshot in the air. Nigeria have jaga. Are you aware that your beloved country have scattered? It has rotten. Nigeria is now poto poto. Nigeria is now a warawa tomato. Children now use Nigeria to play ball. They say when an elder brings himself to the level of children, children will use him and play ball. Children will use him and do anything they feel that is okay for them. That is what your beloved country. Where are the one lovers of Nigeria? Where are those ones clamoring for one Nigeria? We have to stay together as one. We have to manage. Other countries used to have problems. Why is our own different? Nigeria case is different. Nigeria case is different. No this and no peace for the rest of your life. Nigeria case is totally different. I heard that Nigerian government is seeking for the aid of the Americans. It's begging the white people, come and help us. Help you to do what? I'm asking the government of Nigeria, what would they help you to do? To fight terrorists that you don't know who they are? You are not aware of who the terrorists are. Nigeria has turned to a terrorist country. I am asking the government of Nigeria, don't you know where these terrorists are? You don't know who they are? If you don't know them, you have to call Sheikh Gumi. At least he has said it on the television that he has gone to negotiate with these people. They need to give them money. They need to rehabilitate them. They need Western education. They know who they are. Why are you deceiving yourself? Is it American police or army that you're going to tell where the hideout of your kinsmen are? They will not give up. Americans, you have to keep your army. Don't help Nigeria. They don't need help. Nigeria government doesn't need help. They are the ones that created the terrorists. There is a man called Issa Fantami. He should tell them where the hideouts of the terrorists are. You have a link with terrorists. You have sympathy for terrorists. You have love for terrorism. And you are sitting down with them. And they are still talking about not knowing the hideout of these terrorists. I have issue with Osibanjo. Osibanjo came out and said that we should not worry. Very soon Nigeria will be an oasis of peace. Very soon Nigeria will be an epicenter. Where there will be peace. Where there will be harmony. Where the economy will come back. Osibanjo, stop giving us false hope. Stop raising our hopes that you know will be finally dashed against the wall. Yemi Osibanjo, Professor Yemi Osibanjo, the Vice President of Nigeria. Please, we don't want your Bible. Don't give us hope. You were not elected to come and tell people that very soon, don't worry. Because that is not what the white people have been telling their people. And there is good road in America. I don't think that Clinton, George Bush, and all the American presidents, past and present, I don't think they were telling Americans, don't worry, very soon Nigeria will be an oasis of peace. America will be an oasis of peace. And America is the way it is. If that is what they were telling their people, you, Osibanjo, and every other governor of Nigeria will not be traveling abroad for medical checkup. If Americans were telling their people they should not worry, that very soon peace will be restored. A prayer without work is vain. You guys talk a lot. You talk without action. You are giving us false hope, promising people so that we will say amen. As of today, we are tired of saying amen now. We are not going to church. It's a prayer for Nigeria. Amen. We are now acting. The kingdom of God suffered violence. The violence taketh it by force. We are not in that game of coming to be shouting, amen. Nigeria will be better. Amen. When terrorists are not even allowing us to sleep again. When Fulani herdsmen have taken over Nigeria. If hunger doesn't kill you in Nigeria, Fulani herdsmen will kill you. If Fulani herdsmen doesn't kill you, bandits will kill you. Kidnappers will take you. Boko Haram will now swallow you. That is everything that is happening in Nigeria. And Osibanjo sat down. And he said he's a pastor without resigning. What did the Bible say about witches? That be you not equally yoked with unbeliever. He now said, suffer not the witch to live. How can you be dwelling among witches? Among evildoers? Where they sat down and they are perpetrating acts? Nigeria, you know, has gone moribund. You know Nigeria will not stand the test of time. You know Nigeria is not viable again. You know Nigeria is not sustainable. But because you claim you are a pastor, you are giving us hope. The oasis of peace. What have you done ever since you heard that Issa Fantami has a link with terrorists, that he should resign? There's a serious pressure That is a pantami. He is a minister in Nigerian government. He should resign. And Osibanjo said he's a pastor. Why not say that this blood that is pouring every day in Nigeria, I can't stand it as a pastor, I have to resign. It's only in Nigeria that politicians will know that they are not doing anything. They will stay there. They will prefer to die there. But in abroad, ordinary cough, a president will cough. And people don't like the cough. He will tender his resignation letter. But in Africa, where I am, where they born me, God, I don't know how I managed to come here. They will kill themselves there. Every day, 300 people have died. 1,000 people have been slaughtered. And they will come out and say, oh, this thing is shock us. We are so pained. We condole with the victims. Oh, we are so sorry. That is it. No action taken. After another, maybe 48 hours, they will tell you they have just slaughtered another 3,000 people. They will say, oh, we are in shock. Always shocking. Shock absorber. The government of shocking and always condoning and always what? Visiting. That is what they do in Nigeria. Have you seen that you are not even safe as a Nigerian? You that is clamoring for one Nigerian unity. You are not safe. You will not even be alive to enjoy the Nigeria that you are begging to stay as one. You can't be alive to enjoy Nigeria. Give road, do road for the people so that they will not be dying every day. You don't want to do road. You were created to be wicked to the people. God gave you the knowledge. He gave the white man. Go to the white man's land and see heaven. When you travel abroad, you just see that heaven that you are reading in the Bible. Come to Africa. You will see Potopoto. You will see a smelling place. You will see a place that has deteriorated. No infrastructural development. Zero economy. Economy is going down every day. Zero electricity. Zero jobs for the youths. Do you know that if Nigerian government come out today and say, we are going to give 247 electricity, they will do it under 2 months. None of if you can, light will not be blinking in your place. You will not be shouting, up NEPA, around like mad people. Like mad people. You can't be shouting up NEPA. If they want to give you light, they will give you light. But they will not give you light. And they will still be begging you to stay as one. Let us patch it. Why will you be patching something that you know will not work? Why will you be begging us to stay when you know there is nothing we are gaining? What am I gaining as a Nigerian? I want you people to tell me. What have I gained as a Nigerian? What am I gaining that I am called a Nigerian? I am not gaining nothing. So why will I stay? Why should I stay as a Nigerian, I'm asking? And you're saying, don't worry. Please, I don't want anybody that will tell me one Nigeria. Because you are an enemy of the people. Anybody that is still preaching one Nigeria is an enemy of the people. The person is an enemy of the people. You don't understand that an average man in Nigeria cannot eat again. When they sleep, they are not even short of 1 square meal again. And this hopeless, useless, God-forsaken politicians that call themselves leaders in Nigeria have been suffering the people. America, please don't help Nigeria. Don't help them with any military. They are aware of who these terrorists are. They are the terrorists. You know who these terrorists are. Why are you telling America? Please help me and beg America. Don't help these useless, God-forsaken people. You have caused us a lot of pains. The youth are hovering around and you're talking about unknown gunmen. Don't you think that the unknown gunmen are the men and women that you guys comfortably created? You sat down on the table and created these unknown gunmen. Give them light, you will not give them light. Economy has deteriorated. People cannot even use 2,000 naira to eat food again. When you go to the market, oh, you will be shouting, how am I going to do this? Some people will be walking in the market and they'll be talking to themselves. People are now going mad on the street every day because of the economy of Nigeria. And there is a serious hike in fuel when there is no electricity. And you're still begging the same people to sit down and be called one Nigeria. Aren't you wicked? Aren't you evil? Why should I be called a Nigerian? Why? Have you done road? They will give, every day you'll be hearing, $1 trillion was released. $250 trillion was released. Where is this money going to? I'm asking them, where is the money going to? You are not going to see this money in educational sector. You will not see the effect of this money in our hospitals. You will not see the effect of this money in infrastructural development. You will not see the money in hospital or even in electricity. Our lecturers are underpaid. The doctors are underpaid. The workers' salaries are not paid. The youths don't have jobs. They are hopeless and they are useless. And they are hovering around without hope. And they are still telling me that I should remain as one Nigeria. I don't want to curse you. I just don't want to curse you. I'm being very, very conservative with the words so that I don't get angry. Why should you tell me to be one? I should go to church every day and be shouting, amen, amen, pray for Nigeria. Why should I pray for an evil person that is supposed to be wiped away from the surface of this earth? A politician that kept you like this. Uganda presently is using electric vehicles. Are you aware of that? Uganda is an African country. Uganda. And these things that are hovering around that call themselves politicians are busy walking around selfishly and hopelessly. You guys are devil incarnate. When you see an average politician in Nigeria, just know that you're seeing a potential Lucifer. A potential Lucifer. You guys are wicked to the core. Every day people are dying and do you think they are concerned about the people that are being killed? Aren't you heard the shameless Garba show saying that what is happening in Nigeria used to happen everywhere in the world? So because there is killing in Nigeria, the killing should come. There is killing all over the world. You are now accepting the fact that it happened every other place. Let's just take it, swallow it, hook, line, and sinker, no problem. That they are killing people in other parts of the world. That is why Nigeria should also be getting such manner of killing, slaughtering people like where they are killing animals. These are the people that you kept in government. People like Femi Adesina are still part of the government. And you say Nigeria will be good. And you're begging me to stay as one Nigeria. Aren't you stupid to say that? Aren't you useless to tell me to be a Nigerian? Aren't you? Just take a look at the way the country has gone to. It has scattered. It has rottened. And you know the truth is for Nigeria to be separated. Please, I am begging whoever is involved, grant us referendum. We need a date for referendum. That is what we need today. That is what we seriously need, a date for referendum. Let everybody go and develop their regions. Let the Igbo people go and develop their regions. And if any politician will see around, they don't need anybody to tell them what will happen to them. All these people, you should look for where to run to. We need a date for referendum. We are begging whoever that is involved, just give us a date for referendum. We are tired of all this rubbish. We can't contain it any longer. We can't take it any longer. Every day, bad news. We don't have any benefit as Nigerians. We have never benefited anything. Nothing. Instead, they are killing us. They are making sure that we die of hunger. They are making sure that we die of starvation. They are making sure that something good doesn't happen to us, and they are still telling us to stay. Please, a date for referendum. A date Nigeria has staggered. It has scattered. It has rottened. And the graduates are roaming around looking for where to walk at least for 20,000 feet. And some people are coming out telling me that the best thing is for us to get a good leader. What would the good leader do? How would the leader perform the magic? Which leader will perform the magic? Igbo people, I hope by now it has clear from your eyes that it's not about 2023 presidential election. That there is a more serious thing ongoing. Serious things that is ongoing. This is just a preamble of what is yet to come. This is an advert of the men launching. You people have not seen anything. The monsters you created, the youth that you refuse to give job will haunt all of you. That monster that you created is going to swallow all of you. You've seen nothing. Oh, where be you follow? Just be very optimistic, please. I want to beg everybody, do not fall into depression. I understand that the situation of this country can make you to think of suicide. A lot of people are suffering, that is the truth. But please do not think of depression. Just hold on. Stay calm. Freedom is coming. A date for referendum will be fixed. It will happen. Just know that we are living this contraption. We are living this animal kingdom. We are living this smelling entity. I can't be called one with a Hausa man that is drinking urine. I cannot be called one with a Hausa man that is sleeping with Nama. How will I be called one with a Hausa man that will lie Nama on the floor and be using the Nama? How can I be one with somebody that is kissing and romancing a cow? How? Tell me how. Other people are doing greater things in our place. They are talking about cow. And the shameless senators are just sitting down in the Senate House talking rhetoric every day, speaking without action. Nigerian Senate is the worst Senate in the whole of the world. No action is taken because it is not you. But very soon, like I said, this rain will fall everywhere. August everywhere. That time all your eyes will be cleared. Freedom is coming. I know that.